So, witness over here, a very, very old oscilloscope made by Tele-Equipment. And it is old. It is old and dusty and has been sitting in the closet for a while. And the reason I brought it out to show you, it's not so much for this oscilloscope because it's not really all that great of a scope, but the device attached to it, this here, is called a Hameg. And if we can focus, thank you. The Hameg Component Tester HZ65. So what this does is it's a transistor slash diode slash capacitor tester. And so that's what this does. If you want to stick around and find out more, well, stick around. So, what this cute little apparatus does, when you can get to it, is it'll tell you whether or not your capacitors or transistors or resistors are working. It's a pretty crude way of testing the value of a resistor, since it doesn't really give you any kind of readout other than just the line. For transistors, kind of handy. So here we have a basic transistor, and let's see if we can get both in line at the same time here. So, we'll pop this in. Whoa, look at that. So what it's doing is it's utilizing the XY axis of the scope. So, take a look here. The time base is set all the way over to external X input here. That's what this line goes to. That's what this little banana adapter is for, to give us our X axis. As you see, we disconnect it and the X goes away. So pop it in. And likewise, the Y axis is over here on input one. So it's a crude little device, like I said. But you can test components, whether or not they're any good. So right now we're going from junction 1 to 2. And then that's 1 to 3. And that's junction 2 to 3. So that's kind of like what a diode would show. And this is sort of like what the forward voltage drop, what a Zener diode would probably show. In fact, let's get a Zener. Okay, so here's a Zener diode. 7.5 volts is what it's rated for. There's also a couple little banana terminals on the side. You can go into here as well. And yep, my polarity's a little backwards, but yeah, so look at that. It's basically the same as that transistor, about 7.5 volts. And it's also pretty tricky to guarantee any results based on the graticules. It's really just for show. It's not meant to have any real accuracy. There's also a switch here for current loading. Right now it's on minimum. You can throw it over to maximum or medium, and it kind of does a little trick on the waveform. It shows it's starting to bow out a little bit. You don't want to do that too much. We want to keep it on minimum. And what else can we do? Well, you did hear me say something about capacitors, so here's a 10 microfarad cap. Put it in here, think so. Whoa, look at that. So it gives you sort of a lozenge-ish pattern. And, yeah. It's dirty. I have crap contacts. Let's put it into the socket. That's better. So we're in junctions 1 and 2. The socket says 1 and 2 here. And then you can select the other inputs or the other junctions. So, of course, they do nothing because it's just 1 and 2 right now. And, well, you get a different result depending on how much current you're feeding into the capacitor. It's kind of a goofy way to check a capacitor. You know, it's, this is more science fair stuff than anything else. But yeah, I had this thing hanging around and I figured I would show all you. It's, the Hemig HZ65. I actually did look on eBay to see if anyone's had one, and there was someone in in Canada, and they want $139 for it. So hey, maybe I got something that's worthwhile here. Who knows? But is this gonna replace my Fluke? My Fluke 85? Am I going to replace this with this? I don't think so. This does a far more accurate job of reading capacitors and diodes. And, it's a bit more advanced. I can do just fine with that. But it's an interesting thing. And also, can you do this on a Rigel, on a digital oscilloscope, such as that? Tune in next week to find out if you can. So thanks for watching, and get out there and break something today so you can fix it. All right, see you soon.